Sometimes, you don't need groundbreaking discoveries to make an impact on the scientific community. You can just use your tools in a different way. This is the philosophy of a team of young researchers at the Engineering Department of Cambridge University in the United Kingdom. They are building a prototype of a brand new microscope using components already available on the market and a computer, the Raspberry Pi, that costs around $25. The final product will be an affordable, high-quality tool that will help research centers and education projects where resources are limited.
So what we're trying to do is use all the progress that have been made recently in terms of open source software, open source hardware, to build scientific tools in the most general sense that would be useful either for higher education or for research or research and development pretty much anywhere in the world.
In the lab, Marco Silvi, a third-year physics student at Cambridge, showed me the prototype and the automatic tasks it can perform thanks to the Raspberry Pi at its heart.
So what I've been working on is actually putting all the parts of the microscope together to automate some functions. And for example, what the demo will show is how to run autofocusing. But we can show, for example, starting from quite autofocus picture, like that one. We can run this program. That will try to autofocus the image, and then we can display the results. Using a Raspberry Pi makes the whole thing very open source and very cheap. It does provide lots and lots of possibilities. So all the software can be improved, all the electronics as well. What we are providing with our instructions is basically a starting point.
The goal is to find the best way to build a high-quality research tool at a reduced cost, in the belief that science should be for everyone.
So when we first started the project, we looked around at the typical microscopes that were being used in research labs, and most of their microscopes started at least sort of £10,000. And typically, they had many which were costing £50,000, and some which were costing £250,000. So what we decided to do was obviously make a similar functionality, but a much cheaper option. We think that in total, it should cost about £500.
After setting the total price range that they wanted to achieve, the engineers looked for the best solution and value for each component.
Well, I'm Chris. I'm a second-year physics student at Cambridge, and I've been working on the optics, so everything about getting the image from very small things. And one of the big problems with current microscopes is it's very expensive to buy all of the lenses and things that you need. So what I've been trying to do is buy very cheap lenses and put them together easily so that you can cheaply make a very high-quality microscope. And the other thing I've been doing is working with illumination. So it's very important how you light what you're looking at. So that's one of the big challenges is how do you cheaply, using LEDs, get a really good lighting quality so that you can get a really good image.
Today, some components can be 3D printed. For those who don't have an expensive 3D printer, these can be ordered online.
A lot of the tubes we've been using to hold the lenses are very expensive, and they're kind of a standard manufacturing type. So we've been trying to build our own 3D printed optics tubes so that they're very, very cheap, and you can just download the design and print it if you have a 3D printer, and it should work almost as well as the high quality metal stuff. Each one of these tubes costs about 50p to a pound, whereas those cost about $60 per tube.
In the future, open source won't just be a matter of software. Teaching people how to make electronic devices by uploading the instructions onto the internet could pave the way to a new age of equity in science.
We are not trying to develop new cutting-edge technology. We want to design using tools that are available now, which are very much open, which are modular, which are things you can tweak any way you want, build the type of equipment that people use in NAMs, but at the same time provide all the flexibility you need to change it, to rebuild it, to share it with others, to build a community that will progressively make this instrument better, and also trying to keep the whole thing very cheap as much as possible.